What's new in the loo? Tune in.
Step on the blunt, some Louis V. High tops, one eye always open like Cyclops, yeah. Ball like MJ. 23 got hops, I got a stick on me, look like Black Ops. My wrist icy like hockey, the Blackhawks. I got the sauce, might swipe me a track call. Slam dunk with the drink, just did a tomahawk. I got the stick on me, look like Black Ops. Come from zero, but I ran it up like a boss. I had to find me a way, had to give me some sauce. Corona hit hard, I had took a loss. But the loss ain't nothing when you move like a boss. A boss take losses, you might not get it back. Give out a good loan, I ain't never get it back. Niggas be lazy, just wanna piggyback. I shoot a 7.62 like Call of Duty. I'm on that white card, that wild moody. Got more drink than Cinco de Mayo. I with the
Yo, Robbo Brilliant tapping in, man. Burn one, what's new in the loop? Robbo Brilliant, aka Big Trigger.
What's been going on with you, though, man?
Bro, just working, just trying to stay busy, bro. Just grinding, bro. Just every day building, bro. One block at a time, you feel me?
Yeah, I appreciate you just reaching out to me, you know what I'm saying? And, man, I'm amazed by the music that you put out, man.
Right on, bro.
Yeah, I've been looking at the music, bro. You go back and forth, like 5 years doing this, maybe more?
Yeah, bro, like 5 years. It's like really on a professional level, you know what I'm saying? Like, it's 5 years in, bro. Just building, get from there to get from where I'm at now, you know what I'm saying? Like, it'll process, but, you know, where I need to be now.
Now, as far as your start to music, you know, just take me through, you know, how did you get your name and Robbo Brilliant?
Man, you know what's crazy? My old name was Rob Green. A lot of people know me by Rob Green.
Okay. That's playing the green her.
Man, not even that. That's just, I had a tree back in the day, you know what I'm saying? Okay. A couple years ago. So. Everybody just called me Green, but it's another artist in Atlanta. His name Rob Green.
Yeah,
this thing called Rob Green Records. So every time somebody would type in my name, dude would pop up. So I'm like, man, I gotta figure something out. So I mean, everybody call me Robbo too, though. And everybody be like, man, you a genius, you smart. So I just put the Brilliant with the Robbo. You know what I'm saying? So.
And I'm sure you was reading about copyright stuff like that. You know what I'm saying?
Okay. It's gonna be an issue. Every time I drop something, Rob Green, he probably could put a copyright claim. You know what I mean? It's just too much, bro. Pick a different name, you know what I'm saying?
What made you want to pick up the mic in the first place?
Man, I had to figure something out. I had went to the joint, bro. I got locked up, catching cases, bro. Like, so once you catch those cases and you get them felonies, it's like, then you kind of limit yourself on what you can do legally, you know what I'm saying? Like, especially with felonies. So it's like, I just had to start using my talents. I had to figure out a way to use my talents to pay my bills and feed my family, you know what I'm saying? So that's really what it came down to.
What you get jabbed up for if you
want to
get into that?
Oh, man, I had a gun case, unlawful use of a weapon, felon in possession. Yep.
So now the situation
was
made,
you could make it. Like, I did, I got out in 2014.
Okay.
I did 14 months, you know what I'm saying? So I did, like, 4 months in the workhouse, and then the rest in Boonville. While I was in there, that's when I really learned the music game in 2014. I learned like how to write a song, put a song together, understanding what copyrights were. I stayed in the library, you know, I mean, everybody else outside, working out, and just playing pool and all that extra shit, bro. I'm in the library, I'm reading books. Like, I'm still touching base with my outside peers, like on the outside. Shout out to Rimrod, you know what I'm saying? He would hold me down. Young Dark, he was in there with me. Yeah, Young Dark was in there with me. We used to be talking about the plan. So just studying, man, getting the plan together, getting out and executing.
Yeah. Rimrod was like one of the first videographers you linked up with as far as like one of your videos, right?
Yeah, my brother, bro. Like,
okay.
Like, just for everybody that don't know, it's like they always see us together. They see us working together. Like,
okay.
We go back so far, like, before the video. But when it was just an idea for, like, back when he was cutting her, you know what I'm saying? Making beats, you know what I'm saying? Like,
so that you come from that District 6, you know what I'm saying?
Oh, yeah, for sure. Walnut Park West, man, you know?
I'm just gonna say, man, let the people know, man, right there said that they familiar with St. Louis. That's Walnut Park West.
War 27, like, Goodfellow, West Florissant area. I'm from North Point, you know what I'm saying? But Yeah, just that whole little area right there. Right around John's, Lee's, okay. You know what I'm saying? The beauty supply, the circle, like that whole area, bro. You already know.
Yeah, man. What was life like growing up, man? You know, what kind of stuff you find yourself getting into before the music, bro?
Man, the wrong stuff. Nah, go to the environment. You know what I mean? Granny, working all day. I got put out of school, you know what I'm saying? I'm getting in trouble. Pops weren't really around, so it's like, start just, you know, product of the environment. But I learned a lot too, though. Got some real ones over there, you know what I'm saying? Like, learned a lot. Like, I wouldn't change nothing of what I went through. I'll go through it again just to get to where I'm at now. Real.
The song Black Ops, you know what I'm saying? That was hard, you know. What was the whole inspiration
right
behind that song, you know?
Yeah, shout out to my brother EJ Carter, he on there. Just trying to be different, be creative, man. Talk about stuff we do, you know what I mean? Just talk about stuff we own, you know. Just want to make it fun too at the same time, you know what I'm saying? It's the concept from the actual game, Black Ops. If you see the cover, like, we ain't got no real Draco on there, so it's like a video game. Video games, right? You know what I'm saying? So,
okay.
Yeah, just a play on words, you know what I mean? You know how it go.
Yeah, the song dope. You
know, yeah, right on, right on.
You know what I'm saying? I bring that up because, you know, if it was in St. Louis, you know, you see a lot of people, you know, album covers and videos, there's guns everywhere, you know what I'm saying? Like, you know, like a lot of people criticizing the videographers for that stuff, everything, you know, it ain't paid for, but what's your whole take on how you think, like, as far as, like, where the city and the music?
I'm glad you asked me that, man. Every interview I do, they ask me that. And I just feel like artists gotta be smarter. Like, we got a lot of talent here. Like, it's authentic. Like, that's what really sells in music. The streets, you know what I mean? Like, the authenticity. You know what I mean? The originality. Like, and we got it. Like, we got a story. But it's just too incriminating, like, the way it's being presented. Like, y'all gotta find some lingo to put in the music. You gotta find that balance on how to get to sell your product, but not incriminate yourself, not get indicted while you sell it. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
Like, gotta start new words, new lingo. Make it to where the police can't. They can't follow what you're saying. You know what I'm saying? Don't make it easy for them.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like,
because it seems like, you know, from city to city, it's a trend, you know what I'm saying? But, you know, it seems like, you know, St. Louis is always getting overlooked. You know, I have people tell me, well, it's because St. Louis is not originally known for the gangster music, you know what I'm saying? We're known for the dancing, you know what I'm saying? The one-name artist, Chingy, the Nelly,
yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
I mean, you did make, what you say on the book, was that you? And he was like, why is the St. Louis artist can't
get signed?
I mean, we getting signed. But it just really is lack of music business.
Right. Okay.
That's really what it come down to. Like, it's a lot of street business being handled, but it ain't no real music business being handled. Like, ain't making the right resources, ain't presenting it the right way, ain't got your rollout the right way. You know what I mean? Like, they can't. It ain't nothing for nobody to look past besides your IG and some YouTube videos. It's gotta be more than that. You know what I'm saying? Like, it's where it start, reaching out with your local media platform, you know what I'm saying? Like, breaking yourself as an artist, doing the things artists need to do. So it's real simple, bro. It ain't really like no conspiracy why we ain't getting signed. It's just lack of music business, you know?
Lack of education, how about it?
It's hard to transition from street business to music business, though. Like, it's hard, it's real hard, you know what I'm saying? But if you can't do it, you're going to have to find somebody that could represent you and do it for you. That's the only way it's going to work. You know what I'm saying?
Now, touching millions and billions, you know? Man, tell me how that whole thing just came
about. Oh, man, TMB Empire, man. Man. Just had to come up with something that meant something. Like, I didn't want to just come up with a name just for the hell of it. Like, that's really what we be on. Like, it ain't just we try and touch millions and billions of dollars. We going to touch millions and billions of dollars. We going to touch millions and billions of people, millions and billions of fans. Yeah. Me as a business, a household with our music and what we got going on. You know what I'm saying? Like, we showed y'all in 2019. We did the toy drive. You know what I'm saying? So that's what it's about, bro. Just touching millions and billions, bro, in all aspects. You feel me?
I mean, you said we did the toys, right? You know what I'm saying? Now, what was the feedback from that? And then are we expecting any more drives from you? You know what I'm saying? Kids going back to school right now?
Yeah, it's not even going to be just drives. It's going to be a lot. Like, so besides the touching millions and billions record label, which is my brand, like, I got the foundation. It's a nonprofit, it's a charity, you know what I'm saying? Just give back. It really started as giving back to the six, you know what I'm saying? Giving back to Walnut Park West, where I was raised. And just something, you know, something me and my partners we came up with. We want to give back. And we plan to do more. Yeah, we plan to, you know, plan to keep doing more charitable stuff. Giving back. Right and not wrong, you know what I'm saying? Balancing stuff out, you feel me?
What's some artists under touching millions and billions, and we can expect to hear stuff from in the future?
Man, nobody really signed me right now. Like, it's just a brand I'm pushing. Like, I got a lot of partners that's affiliated, though. I told them, though, like, you know, like, it's family. Like, it ain't really got no paperwork. And I really ain't found the right artist yet, to be honest. But my partner, Kilogram, the show, TMB, look out for him. Lil Zap.
Absolutely.
Like I say, we ain't found no artists for real yet. So y'all artists watching. Y'all got y'all stuff together, man. Y'all want to put some flame on the fire, like gasoline on the fire. Let me know. Like, we always looking to network.
Do you produce as well?
Yeah, I produce. I produce some of my own songs. I don't produce a whole lot, but I can if I need to. You know what I'm saying?
Other business ventures that you were into outside of music. You know what I'm saying? I said you got things for cars, you know what I'm saying?
Oh, man.
You talk about the real estate. You know?
Yeah, man. I got into cars, man, after this. Going through cars.
Yeah.
Like, I'm like a currency, bro. That's like my hobby, you know what I'm saying? Like, outside of music, bro, I'm at car clubs.
Okay. That's dope. What car club you in?
I'm a couple different. I'm in the Acura car club.
Oh, damn, okay.
Yeah, I'm in some Toyotas with some boys. They got some Supras, some, you know, turbo Camry, you know what I'm saying? But, yeah, just something, you know, you got to do what you like, bro. Like, I don't just be rapping all day long, bro. Like, I still got a life outside of music, so. But business-wise, bro, get a lot of crypto. Okay. That's the move right now. So anybody looking to invest, anybody want to make some money, long-term residuals, man, hit me up, man. That's all we on right now, crypto.
Okay, yeah, that's what's up, man. How you feel about Bitcoin right now? You know what I'm saying? What this vibe's looking to be right now, man? What's up, man?
I mean,
you must know how to play it, right?
That EOY, man, that's what it really comes down to, end of the year, you know what I'm saying? End of the year, what everybody looking forward to, like. Okay. That's how I go, up and down. You just gotta hold, though. Like, don't panic, don't sell, just hold, you know what I'm saying? Invest what you can afford to invest. Like, I ain't saying put your last or take a loan and put on some crypto. I'm just saying, like, got some extra few dollars laying around you want to put somewhere, go in crypto. But man, we've been on crypto for a minute, man. My boy Rimrod, back to Rimrod.
See, I started like around that
2012, when Bitcoin was like 1200. Yeah, we hopped on, like, we ain't, you know, we learned along the way, like, we ain't capitalized like we should have, but, like, we was definitely ahead of the curve, though, you know what I'm saying? And just networking with other people that be in the crypto, you gotta stay current. It's the future, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, you think it's gonna get to a point where, you know, the dollar is gonna be obsolete, not even, like, even thought about it anymore? Cash will always be king.
Cash always be king. You see a lot of places now with COVID.
Right.
Can't use your card cash only. You know what I'm saying? Like, cash gonna be king ultimately. That crypto though, they got crypto machines up just like they got ATMs up though.
Yeah, that's good.
You know what I'm saying? So. lot of them establishments, they accept cryptocurrency as a form of, as a method of payment, so, you know.
Now, you know the pandemic rocked the real, you know what I'm saying? So just, do you have kids, though? And then they old enough, they like elementary yet?
I got a daughter. She's five. She start kindergarten Monday, actually, on the 23rd of August.
So how you going about, you know, the whole process?
That 23rd? Monday the 23rd?
Next Monday, I think.
Yeah.
I think so. All right, look at the cat. I should be, though.
Oh, okay, yeah. She's going to go.
What approaches are you taking, man? How you adjusting to this whole new thing, man? You got people that's getting the shot, people that's not getting the shot. You know, how you going about taking your daughter to school? You know, how you feel about that?
I mean, everybody masked up. That's what I like about the school, you know what I'm saying? Like, everybody, man, when I went to open house, everybody masked up. Teacher had on masks, students already had on masks. Nobody had to tell nobody to put no mask on, you know what I'm saying? So, I like it, bro. I'm a fan of the masks, you dig what I'm saying? Like, everybody, you know, everybody can be nasty amongst themselves. I ain't gotta be in line and you coughing on breathing on
me. Right, the mask.
You know what I'm saying? Coughing the mask. Like that whole time period, bro.
Yeah,
for the pandemic though, like, bro, my daughter never caught a cold. I never even seen, bro, just because everybody was containing their germs to themselves.
This guy doesn't have a mask.
But, yeah, I mean, I like it.
Now, your past project, you know, you got psychiatry such as Real One, New Energy, you know, Rock, you know what I'm saying, name a few.
Oh, yeah, the releases, yeah.
You know, what's your plans, you know, going into the rest of 2021 for music? You know, are you expecting any more visuals, any more new music from you?
Oh, yeah, I got the Now or Forever project. EJ Carter. Like 7 songs.
Okay.
I got some visuals I've been sitting on. Me and him, we gonna knock out visuals probably for Black House. Okay. Probably 2 other joints. But I got a project coming out with DMV artist from Maryland. Jigga Flame, shout out Jigga Flame. So this all fourth quarter material. You feel what I'm saying? So yeah, we just loading the clip, that's all.
Now you tapped in with the DMV, man. Did you go out there? How did you look up? How you make that connection happen?
I went out there, I went to Maryland.
Okay. What's the music scene like out there?
It's definitely gutter. Like street. Okay. Like it's street. Like I like it. Remind me of St. Louis, but it's just a little different, like the way they talk. I mean, they lingo, but it's the same. Yeah, I went out there, man. People kept telling me about Jigga. So I reached out, like, look, I'm in your area. Like, you put something together. We locked in to the yo, locked in. Just developed that relationship. So shout out Q the Fool, too, man. Q the Fool. Yeah. I rock with DMV, man.
Me, man. I'm thinking, like, they got that kind of that. That Shy Glizzy type of style.
Yeah, shout out to Glizzy.
Kind of that go-go vibe out there.
Yeah, shout out to Hefe. Yeah. Yeah, they just different out there. I like it though, you know what I'm saying? Like, they be about business down there, so.
Yeah. How long you known EJ, you know?
I've been knowing EJ off and on for like a couple years now, 3 years. Okay. But
through the music.
Yeah, just, you know, we got a lot of mutual friends.
A lot of mutual friends.
Yeah, so it's like we peers in this, you know what I'm saying? So online, be in the same places, so. And I reached out to him, like 2018, I think it was 2019. I reached out to him to work on a song. We shot a video that From the Loop. Then we just established a working relationship after that. Like it went from one song to two songs to let's do an EP together to bro, what you on this weekend? Bruh. You know what I mean? Like we just developed a relationship. So yeah, shout out to EJ, bro. Shout out to the whole red shirt freshman, man. So yeah, that's the bro, so.
Yeah, how you feel about the city overall right now as far as just everything? You know, because it seems like you're going up, man. Say Cheese just came out here. Interviewed D. Huncho, he interviewed Lil Tay, he interviewed Grammy. He interviewed them before though, man, but you know, okay. He just shouted out Blanco, matter of fact.
Mm-hmm.
When he was interviewing D. Huncho, I'm watching before I blew it up.
No, it working, like, that's the music business I'm talking about. Yeah. It need to be handled, like, it's a good look, bro, like, artists breaking. I mean, it's just a lot of talent here, a lot of artists got stories, and like, that's how you break it, you know what I'm saying? Like, that's how you do it. And artists got to stick together. You know what I mean? We can't be to the point to where it's so much smoke, like, we can't even be in the same building or the same event together. I can't be that. Like, we got to get the money first. You know what I'm saying? Chicago showed you that. Like, yeah, they kill, they slide, they do what they do, but they get to the money first before that. You know what I mean? That's why you see all the, they go back and forth for so long, everybody run their money up.
Right.
Then, then a partner get pushed, some, but it's like, man, we gotta get the money first.
I mean, what's some goals you plan on accomplishing with your career and this with your brand?
Man, just to have other artists who serious under my brand, you know what I mean? That I could push and give them the same resources I got. And shit, just really, for real, just keep dropping music, keep building the audience up, keep doing shows, bigger tours, you know what I mean? Bigger events.
You got a huge following, man. Just tell people what it took for you to get that following up, you know, because, you know, you're doing pretty good for yourself.
Right. God. Man, like I say, block by block, building it. Like, engaging with my fans. Like, I ain't one of them artists, like, if I post something and you make a comment, like, I'm gonna reply. You know what I'm saying? I'll reply to everybody. Like, if you DM me, like, I'm gonna get back to you. You know what I'm saying? So, it just building that rapport with your audience, with your fans, staying consistent for them, like engaging with them, interacting with them, like that's what it's about.
Yeah. You say you finna live it with some other podcasts, man. What you got going on so much with that? You know what I'm saying? You're working, man. Before we get out here.
Oh, for sure. Shout out to Views from the Arch. We knocked out our interview with Forrest Park like a day ago. Shout out to him. 26, Blind City. Shout out to Blind City. So that's coming up. Man, I think the 23rd, I got Artists United Network. Shout out to them boys too. So I got a thisis50.com interview dropping. So yeah, I'm just trying to keep it in motion, bro. Yeah, I'm just trying to keep it in motion, bro.
That's a big deal.
Yeah, I got a lot of that going on, bro. Like, I'm just, this whole month, bro. Like, I'm just trying to grind, bro. Like, be where I need to be. You know what I'm saying? Do what I need to do as an artist. Blind City. That's what he titled his podcast. We gonna be on it called Game on the Yard. We gonna have his people on there. We gonna be chopping it up. But yeah, my advice, bro, is just come up with a plan. Like, use that time to really get to know yourself and come up with a plan and the execution on when you get out. Cause them doors, one thing about them doors gonna open up at some point. You know what I mean? So have a plan, get out, hit the ground running. Like, don't even look back. Like, just execute. That's all it's about. You know what I mean? Get faith in God too. You know what I'm saying?
Definitely, man. You follow any religions or you just really got your relationship with God?
Yeah, man. I'm in the church, bro. Like, okay. I'm raised on Jesus, bro. That's how I'm raised. Like, all I seen growing up, I see it working. You know what I'm saying? Working in people in my family that really practice Christianity. Like, I see it work. It has worked. It prayers and work. You know what I'm saying? Like, I'm out the jam. I done been a couple jams, bro. I'm sitting right here. I ain't supposed to be free, for real. I ain't supposed to be alive. But some Christian prayers, bro. So,
if you get through it.
Yeah, so this is what I seen that work. You know what I'm saying? So, yeah, just stay locked in. You know what I'm saying? Like, I don't ever give up, man. Keep grinding. Everybody keep doing their thing. You know what I'm saying? Like, don't stop. Don't let nobody tell you to stop. Like, keep your faith in God, faith in yourself. You're going to be successful straight up.
I have to ask you, man, how many tattoos you got, bro?
Oh, yeah, it's the north side. I got a gang on, bro. I lost count. You know what I'm saying? Like, I'm hit up for sure. You know what I'm saying? But that's why big trendy, man. You know what I'm saying?
Man, what you got you into getting the ink, man? You know?
Bro,
how old was you when you first had that first one?
Man, my first one? I'm like 16.
Oh, okay. Off the porch, man.
Yeah, I told you, my grain was at work.
Yeah.
I had no supervision. So I'm doing, that was my best idea at that time. Don't go to school, go get a tattoo. She tried her best, y'all, so, you know.
What's some good studios in St. Louis to go to, you know?
Oh, man. Shock City. I got a shout out to bro, Shock City. Go holler at Sam, tell him Robbo sent you. Suburban. Got some good engineers down there. Carter, 88 Keys.
Okay. Major 88 Keys.
Yeah, my cat too. What's up, 88?
My boy right there.
Sawhorse cool. So, them are the top three I know of. Hey, this juice fire, my boy.
Thank you, man.
Man, this is it. This is it. I will be back, for sure.
I mean, shout out to Fox Park Smoothie, you know.
Oh, man. Fox Park, man, for sure.
Yeah, I'm gonna try to see that real quick. We back up here, you know.
Yeah. Health is wealth, I'm telling you.
Our part is, what's some ways that you looking after your health, you know?
Right here.
Drinking smoothies.
Workout stuff like that.
Not drinking soda.
Yeah, I had to stop drinking soda too, bro, because I had an incident a couple weeks back where my appendix felt like it was fucking, I don't know, I thought it was dead, but they were saying it might have been kidney stones.
Man, the brother who run my mail route where I'll be at, he just got back. He was down 4 months, had to get his appendix taken out.
Okay.
Yeah, so. Health as well, man. Stay hydrated, work out. You know what I mean? Lay off the drugs or balance it out.
Right.
Like, sweat it out.
Because I heard the Joe Clark song where you said that, you know.
Oh, yeah, you know what it is? Like, drink, you know what I mean? Yeah. But we balance it out, though. You know what I'm saying? Like, we doing the drink. The drink ain't doing nothing. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, right.
This ain't no drink. What's this? Hey. It's a time and place for that, you know what I'm saying? But the drink, we got the drink too though.